Okay, so we're in Perek Lamed Gimel and Shaar Dalet, approaching seeing the light at the end of the tunnel, or the darkness at the end of the Sefer, whatever. And so last week in Perek Lamed Beis, we were talking about Torah's ability to straighten a person out and save him from the Yetzer Hara. Right? It's the antidote, it has just the right antibodies from the Yetzer Hara that HaKadosh Baruch Hu created. And that was the story back then. And if you get rid of the antibodies, it's like getting rid of the medicine, the only medicine that could help. Get rid of that medicine, you're doomed. Okay, so we're going to continue this thought in this chapter as well. Okay, so let's see. Perek Lamed Gimel. And therefore, nitztavinu ba'azhara neiro mipivis baruch. Therefore, we were commanded, because of this life-saving nature of the Torah, we were commanded with an awesome azhara, an awesome warning, mipivis baruch, from the mouth of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, lo yomosh sefer ha-Torah ze mipicho, that the sefer ha-Torah should not cease from your mouth, v'agisa bo yoyman v'layla, and you should study it day and night. Mm-hmm. You should recite it, or you should speak in it day and night. U'kmashikosav be'azharas, be'agdomas ha-Zohar, and as it is written in the introduction to the Zohar, toch hazi, come and see, kama hu chela takifa daraisa, how powerful is the strength of the Torah, v'kama hu ilo al koilo, and how much above everything it is, u'begin kach, it is because of this, boy le levarnash, it's necessary for a person, li'ishtadolo, to make an effort, be'araisa in the Torah, yumama v'leilio, day and night. And he should not cease from it. That's what it's written. You should talk in it day and night. But if he removes himself, if he separates himself, or separates from it, as if he separates himself from the tree of life. Okay? All right, so that's the source. Because it is the tree of life, so we need it constantly, always. It has to be constantly. Okay, let's see. Ubitana de Beliao Seder Liozuto Perakut Gimel Omar Bishtadel Odom Beatzma Bidivir Torah, and a person should make an effort by himself in the learning of Torah. Shedivri Torah Hem Meshulim Belechem Ubimai, because Torah is compared with bread and water, right? Lamedcha, to teach you, shikashem shi'efshulei lo'odim la'amayt b'loy lechem b'loy mayim, just like it's impossible for a person to continue without bread and without water, kach i'efshulei lo'odim la'amayt b'loy Torah, so too it's impossible for a person to continue without Torah. Shenemar, as it says, lo yomosh sefer ha-Torah zem epicho, this Torah should not cease from your mouth. Okay, v'chein omer b'tanchum v'parshas tavoi, b'posuk v'hoyim shemoyo v'parshas ha'azino, other sources, same idea. Right, so it's an essential as bread and water. Essential as bread and water. Mm-hmm. Right, the last parsha, he told us about, the famous story with Rabbi Akiva, right? Rabbi Akiva, this papus, told Rabbi Akiva, why are you going against the Roman decree and studying Torah when the Romans prohibit it, right? And then Rabbi Akiva told him, we're like fish, like a fox, and the whole give him a whole story. The fox standing by the river and tells the fish, come out, I'll save you. And the fish say, in the water we may live, we may die, but if we come out of water, that's certain death, right? I heard an interesting pshat. This is somebody, Rebbe in Sinai, told me this pshat just last week. He heard himself in some bar mitzvah in Lakewood, and from Rabbi Swerdlov, I think, if I remember correctly, that he asked the question, why do we compare it to the fish? They need water. Water is a necessity, just like we saw over here. B'lechem u'mayim. It's the water, and bread and water is a necessity for everyone, right? Why do we specifically say the fish, like a fish out of water? A person without Torah is like a fish out of water. Mm-hmm. It's like a cow out of water. It's like a horse out of water. Like a human out of water. Mm-hmm. I mean, anybody without water, right? So the pshat is, I mean, not complicated, but the pshat is that everybody needs water as a drink, right? We consume water as a necessary nutrient.
Mm-hmm.
We need it to live, yes, but it's just a nutrient, right? Fish consume water through their gills, right? They need it like we need air, right? So for them, it surrounds them. It's their whole environment. It's their whole life force. It's everything, right? So therefore, so that's why we compare it. For us, it's more than just food and nourishment. It is our whole existence,
mm-hmm.
right? Basic, I mean, basic, right? I mean, he added, I think, also the how do you know where you're holding? If it's just nourishment for you, if it's your whole existence. So then he says, I think that's the parable, is it what are you doing in the time of danger? What are you doing when it's difficult? Or how, you know, if you're still learning Torah like Rabbi Akiva, even in the time when it's dangerous, then you know that you're on that, you know, again, Rabbi Akiva is Rabbi Akiva, but I'm saying that's the lesson of it there, that even when it's like the most difficult and the person still attaches himself to Torah, so you know this person is living it. It's water for him, like fish is water. It's like air, right? Okay. So that's the idea. That Torah has to be, I mean, we have to be surrounded by it. We have to think about it. We have to live it. Okay, good. Let's continue. Bomar Kosov, and so the pasuk says, "Eitz Chaim Hilam Achazikim Bo." It is a tree of life to those that support it. Kitzorich Odom Lekboya Boliba. This is a beautiful moshul. That a person has to set this idea in his heart, v'idame b'dayt, and he has to imagine it in his mind, ki ilu hoyo teveya b'nachal shoytev, that he is as if he is drowning in a powerful river, in the rapids of a powerful river, v'roya lefonov b'nohar ilan chozak, and in front of him, he sees a solid tree. V'adai, certainly, ya'amitz koyach, he will pull all of his strength together, his aches, in order to grab onto his dabeg atzma and attach himself, boy, to that tree, b'kol koichoy, with all of his strength. Right?
Mm-hmm.
This is his last chance to survive. He's gonna, you know, do whatever he can to grab onto it. V'lo yarpe yodav himeno afilu rega achad, and he's not gonna let go of that tree for even a second. Right, achar shirak bezer toli ata kol chiyusa, because this is the only way that he can actually survive. Mi pesi v'layoven, who is a foolish one who doesn't get this? Shem yisatzel chas v'sholom afrega echad, that if he just lets go for even a brief second, v'yar peyodav misachis boy, and you know, weakens his grasp on this, yid batechav, he will immediately drown. Right, so again, this is his view of the world. I mean, this is our view of the world, is that the world of Gashmius is by its very nature is the antithesis kind of what Ruchnius is, right? So a person by definition, you know, he has to do he's going against the flow, right? The nature of the Gashmius is pulling a person down, is limiting him. And their only way to break free is to be continuously connected to the Torah. Let go, sucks you right in. But if you that connection is continued, so then you're still holding on. You know, you may get bruised up, you may get beat up, you may get whatever, you may get air into your water into your nostrils and whatnot. But as long as you're holding on, you're still okay. So, Keina Torah Kadosha, similarly, our Holy Torah, Nikris Eitz Chaim, is called the Tree of Life, Ilona Dechaya, Tree of Life, Shirak Oysoi Ha Eis, Sha'odom Ochuz Bahavoso, that only at that moment that a person is holding on to the love of the Torah, V'oysek, and he's involved, Mehagbo B'kvius, and he has a set time, you know, meaning it's not just, okay, whenever I have the time, I pick up a book. It's, you know, he learns it as it's kaveya. What's the word? It's deeply planted into his life. Ozu chay chayim. Then he's living the life. Hamitim halyonim, the true life and the lofty life. Koshur v'dovu kaviyochel b'chay olomim. Then he's tied and he's connected, he's attached to the source of life, to the one who gives life to the world. Says Baruch Shmoy, blessed be his name. The Kudsha Brichu ve'Arayis Echad, who, because again Hashem and Torah are one. V'imchas v'sholom yezniach talmudav. God forbid he lets go of his learning, u'poirish mikviyus ha'esik bo, and he separates from its set, that feeling of setness, that feeling of it being foundational, lasik behavli ha'oilam v'hano'oisov, and he goes and involves himself in the emptiness of the world and its pleasures, hu nifsak v'nichras me'achayim ha'olyonim. He is separated and he's cut off from the life of loftiness. And he drowns himself in the b'mayim hazeidonim, in the evil waters. Rachmanu litzlan. Okay? Mm-hmm. I mean, that's a very, what's the word? A good musar shmus, you know. Okay. U'bezoyer v'yeitzek ufna nun beiz, zakoyin inun Yisrael. Fortunate are those Jews, the kutsha brichu yehavlan raisa dikshoit. Hashem gave them a raisa, the Torah dikshoit, that is true. Leish tadola bo yamam v'layla, in order to make an effort in it day and night. The hokol man the yishtanu v'raisa, and if anybody who involves and puts an effort into the Torah, is lecheiru mikol, then he has freedom from everything. Cheiru min moisa, he has freedom from death. The lo yochlu l'shalto olay, and has no power over him. Why begin to call man the yishtadl v'arayis? Because everybody who is learning and puts an effort into Torah v'yisachid ba and connects with it, yisachid b'ilona dechaya, he is connecting himself with the tree of life, v'yarpig armei m'ilona dechaya. But if he weakens himself from the tree of life, ho ilona demoiso shariyola, then the tree of death is kind of resting, hovering over him. And he's connected to that. Ahudiksiv, it is written, Hisrapisom. There's a pasuk in Mishlei, something like Hisrapisa b'yom tzara. Hisrapisa b'yom tzara, something koychecha. Basically, if you weaken yourself on the day of tzara, meaning like on the day of trouble, right? Something your strength will be weakened. Something along those lines. So I think the basic pshat in the pasuk is that if you're gonna be weak, meaning you're not gonna help your friend when he needs you in his time of trouble, then you're losing out in the long run because he's not gonna help you at your time of trouble. I think that's the basic meaning of the text. And the Medrash is saying, the Zohar is saying, is that if you weaken yourself from the study of Torah on the day when it's difficult, so something yukachecha, meaning your whole strength, your whole power, I guess your whole energy source is diminished. Okay. So v'kama tzorich odom litkoya v'likboya zeh ha'inyan anor b'machshoves libe baltimoy. How much does a person has to internalize and to drill this idea, this awesome idea in his heart, without baltimoy, that should not disappear. Shekol ha'odom v'chayev hu rak oiser ha'es, because the entirety of a man and the entirety of his life, hu rak oiser ha'es shehu dovuk b'Torah Kadosh, is only at that moment that he is connected to the Holy Torah. Okay, everything. So again, this is it. You know. This is like the grand finale. But I mean, this is what you were saying, we were talking before, is that the sum total of it, that everything is the Torah. Right? This is the Litvish approach. The Torah is everything. It is Shekol Ha'adam. It's the entirety of man and the entirety of his life. Okay? So you're only alive when you're learning. When you are learning. You're only alive...